first ride on this Mako 360. Feels great. Got the orange polymers, the yellow Sharkbite. Overall, softer fit. Pretty awesome. First 5 minutes on it, feels great. I don't know.
That was impressive.
I have no idea. I thought for sure I was going to die. I think I'm going to have to try this one again.
Yeah, this part kind of sucked.
Yeah.
I kind of forgot where the turn was.
I might need first gear for this. And this is where I'm gonna struggle. Too bad. This 200 just can't lug if you get going way too slow in second gear.
Yeah.
But first gear, it's great. Literally won't ever stall on you.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. I want to give a quick overview on my thoughts about the Mako 360. So I have a softer setup, and I noticed there's really not a ton of information on YouTube specifically, or really out there anywhere, about softer setups for the Mako. And I just want to say that it's really awesome. I've noticed that the day after riding, my recovery is actually noticeably better. And during the ride, I experienced less arm pump as well. If you have any questions, please let me know and I'll definitely respond. And with that, I hope you enjoy the rest of the video.
Oh. Nailed that tree on his body. Slipping and sliding into there. That was third gear. That's just bad. Now I got arm pump.
Got some arm pump.
Yep. Keeps going that way. Okay. What is that noise? If anyone knows, let me know. Where's it going? Did he really go over that? What? I'm gonna cut around it. There goes the bike. It's nice. Oh, this is like really f***ing hard. That's insane. I realized I was not supposed to be going that way. I don't know how I keep missing you. That would be really tough to get over that log and like not die.
Yeah, you just put the turn right here.
Actually worked. How long this thing is. Dude, I got like a 12-foot tree stuck in my sprocket. It's like wrapped around like three times.
That'd be good. At least it was flexible and didn't break anything.
That was cool. That's...
No. That was a little rough.